Good morning. Good morning, Spirit of Life family. Welcome everyone this morning. Welcome for this good pattern that we have in life, the pattern that we have in all things, to remember to place God first in our lives. As we gather each week for worship, as we continue to worship, may you know the sense of God. May you know the Spirit. May the Holy Spirit speak in you and through you as we find the pattern in this cold morning. As we're reminded of the seasons, as we're reminded of the changes, it's in all of this that may we know God's presence. So welcome this morning. We're grateful that each one of you, that all of you are here. An important announcement this week, remember, next week we're having a celebration service at church. It's going to be really celebratory. It's going to be kid family friendly. Some chances of familiar things to sing along with. And just a good chance for us to have a good old-fashioned revival in our church parking lot. So in the same way, for it to be welcoming, my goal is to keep the service managed in a timely way so that I also know how that goes of being in your car. So next week, know that we're going to manage the service for people to come and to share in that opportunity for when the time comes. There's going to be a chance so that it doesn't go too long. There will be breakfast. That's another exciting thing of the celebration. It's going to be the Browsey family is managing breakfast in a way it's going to be delicious with all the precautions made as they prepare to help welcome, as we prepare to help welcome all of you. And so mark your calendars. We encourage you to, as you are able, it will also be broadcast. So for those unable, please join us. But let's see if we can pack the parking lot next week. If you have other announcements that you wish to be shared, I will make sure to get those in. Make a comment here in the chat, and I will keep my eyes out for those. And let us now. Let us enter into this worship with all of our hearts, minds, and souls, and all of our strength. Let us worship God together.
The call to worship. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless God's name. Tell of God's salvation from day to day. Declare the Lord's glory among the nations, God's marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. God is to be revered above all gods, for all the gods of the people are idols. But the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before the Lord. Strength and beauty are in God's sanctuary.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
The Prayer of Reconciliation. We are called to imitate Christ, but too often we create our own idols, placing other things above God. We are called to be in the world, but not of it. Yet we fail at making our discipleship that which is distinctive about us. Nonetheless, God is merciful and abounding in steadfast love. Therefore, we are confident in the coming before the Lord with our honest confession. Let us pray. Life is complicated. It is full of ups and downs, of good times and hard times, of pleasure and pain. Right now, so many feel alone. Right now, we are so divided. It is hard when we seek to follow you and yet see so many making decisions that harm others. Remind us that Jesus knew the vulnerability and frailty of the human form, the human life. He was hungry and thirsty, cold and lonely, and yet he never gave up. He never gave in. He knew you were with him, always. And that there would come a time when the pain and the trials would end. Love would win. This life seems like a long one, but it is a speck in the universe. In the blink of a light, a blink in the light of eternity. We must trust in the light, hope in your word, and live in your presence. For love will win in the end, always and eternally. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you for those good words. Friends, the Lord our God answers. The Lord our God hears. And the Lord our God forgives us. The mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting. Knowing all of this, hear the good news. It's in Jesus Christ that you are forgiven. Amen. May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you now. Let us now share that peace of Christ with one another.
The Prayer of Illumination. What more, Lord, could we ask for than the promise of your presence with us, your presence that gives us rest? Send your Spirit to open us to your word, read and proclaimed, that we might hear and find rest for our souls and bread for the journey. Amen.
Amen. Amen. As Becky gets ready to share the scripture with us, as I was preparing the sermon, I'm like, man, it just jumps right in. And so I want to share a little bit of the backstory of what's leading into this reading. I think it helps us in context. I think it helps us try to understand everything that is going to be read, and then it's going to help connect the sermon. And so before our reading, lots leading up. Hannah's longing. She is longing for so much. So the story begins with Hannah's husband, Elkanah, who had two wives, Hannah and Peninnah. So there's Hannah and there's Peninnah. And Peninnah had children, but Hannah did not. In fact, Peninnah had many children. Elkanah would go every year to the temple from his town to worship and sacrifice to the Lord of hosts. He would travel to Shiloh. And so on the day when Elkanah sacrificed, he would give portions. He would give portions to his wife Peninnah and to all of her sons and daughters. But Hannah, he gave double portion because he loved her. So can you sense some jealousy right there? There's some jealousy of a favorite. But to Hannah, he gave double. Though the Lord had closed her womb. And so think of in the time frame of the scripture of how much it meant, how important it was for a woman to be able to bear children. And yet Elkanah really loved Hannah. But yet the trouble that she had, that she was unable to bear children. So because of this, her rival, Peninnah, would provoke her severely. She's hurting, and hurt people. Yet she has everything in the worldly that she has the most important thing that Hannah longs for. So you can picture rivalry. So there's rivalry. And it went on year by year. As often she went to the house of the Lord, she used to provoke her. Therefore, Hannah wept. Hannah wept and would not eat. Her husband Elkanah said to her, "Hannah, why do you weep? Why do you not eat? Why is your heart so sad? Am I not more to you than 10 sons?" So there's a lot of conflict. There's a lot of rivalry. There's a lot happening. There's a lot of struggle. And so that's the beginning of the story as now Becky shares the reading with us today.
A reading from 1 Samuel chapters 1 and 2. After they had eaten and drunk at Shiloh, Hannah rose and presented herself before the Lord. Now Eli the priest was sitting on the seat beside the doorpost of the temple of the Lord. She was deeply distressed and prayed to the Lord and wept bitterly. She made this vow, "O Lord of hosts, if only you will look on the misery of your servant and remember me and not forget your servant, but will give to your servant a male child, then I will set him before you as a Nazarite until the day of his death. He shall drink neither wine nor intoxicants, and no razor shall touch his head." They rose early in the morning and worshiped before the Lord. Then they went back to their house at Ramah. Elkanah knew his wife Hannah, and the Lord remembered her. In due time, Hannah conceived and bore a son. She named him Samuel, for she said, I have asked him of the Lord. Hannah prayed and said, "My heart exalts in the Lord. My strength is exalted in my God. My mouth derides my enemies because I rejoice in my victory. There is no holy one like the Lord, no one besides you. There is no rock like our God. Talk no more so very proudly. Let not arrogance come from your mouth. For the Lord is a God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed. The bows of the mighty are broken, but the feeble gird on strength. Those who were full have hired themselves out for bread, but those who were hungry are fat with spoil. The barren have borne 7, but she who has many children is forlorn. The Lord kills and brings to life. He brings down to Sheol and raises up. The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He brings low, he also exalts. He raises up the poor from the dust. He lifts the needy from the ash heap to make them sit with princes and inherit and seat a seat of honor. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and on them he has set the world. He will guard the feet of his faithful ones, but the wicked shall be cut off in the darkness. For not by might does one prevail. The Lord, his adversaries shall be shattered. The Most High will thunder in heaven. The Lord will judge the ends of the earth. He will give strength to his king and exalt the power of his anointed."
Amen. Amen. In all things. This is the story of Hannah. And in all things, give it to God. In all things. In the deepest lows, in our greatest highs. Praise be to God. give it to God. In life and death, we belong to God. This is Hannah's story, a story of life. A life with so much of this that maybe in one way or another, it's all so real. And all that is hard and all that is good. You see, Hannah was barren. Still today, for many, this is so hard for those longing for a child. It's even harder when you try everything. So much in the word for all of us in our longings to come up short. So much of this may be different. But we all know in one way or another, we know the desert. We know barrenness. We know what it is to be longing for something deep down, that deep in our bones, that longing. And in this, whatever that is in you, this is the power of the story of Hannah. A woman who has faithfully been going to God in prayer through all of this. She's been faithfully going to God with her deepest longings. Lord, know my hurt. Lord, know my deepest hurts, my deepest longings. Remember me. And if you grant this, if you give me a child, I will give this child back to you. Remember me, God. Search me. Know me. If you will only give me a child. How many times has she prayed this prayer? How many times has she said, how long, oh God? And finally, Hannah gets this son, this one that she's longed for her whole life. What does she do? She remains faithful. She grants her son to God. She trusts her son into God's care. This is the thing about centering ourselves with God in all of our longings, right? Of not saying what sounds good, of not having to say the right words, or what we think God may want to hear. But the real ones lift up that the deepest within us. Not only does God already know, but there's something in the long run that is healing with this. For in God's ears, it's the beginning of planting new life for us. Knowing that this is a relationship. And that relationship only grows closer when we share the deepest. That in life, to know that in life, that we belong. That we belong to God. So Hannah, in her faithfulness, through sharing everything with God, is aware that our children belong more to God than they do to me. My children belong more to God than to me. Our children belong more to God than they do to us. It's the opposite of being a helicopter parent, where she gives what she knows already to be God's, to allow him to fully become who God has called him to be. There's reward in this. There is reward in trusting to that our children with God. There's insight in this for all of us. And as a parent, I know how much I love my children and what I wouldn't do for them. In the same way for our Spirit of Life children, right? What wouldn't we do for our children? May we hear in this that it's more than just our children. It's with everything. To trust with everything that God gives us, all of the gifts. That's the beauty of this story. That in so many ways, we're seeing the culmination in the opening of the story and our struggles as a people now. Think about it. With all of the rivalry, with all of the hurt people, with all of the needing to be right rather than living rightly. There's deeper meaning in this. So as we know in in our scripture, especially in our Hebrew scripture, but Jesus continues with this. But there is meaning in a name. Hannah, the name Hannah means favored. So here the barren one is favored. Peninnah, the other wife, means fertile or prolific. And as our story today reminds us in the beginning, she is a rival to Hannah. Where we have this deep longing for Hannah. We have this rival whose name is Hannah's longing. And we have a husband for both that favors one over the other, which together means we are going to need a lot of therapy. Seriously, consider all of the hurt here. Consider all of the pain. The one who is prolific in a time that this means everything for identity. The one who has everything that Hannah wants. So we have this, and then we have Hannah who remains faithful, who she doesn't have and she longs for, but she still helps show us that whatever we are without, that if we have our priorities in order, if we have them organized correctly, if not just out of faithfulness, that is, if we have God above everything else in our life, if God comes before everything, we already have everything we need. Amen. This was the message with our kids this week and Meet in the Middle. This was the message of the parable this week. It's the parable of building a house upon a rock. As the kids answered this question so well, whatever struggles may come, whatever storms may come our way, whatever is going to happen, if we build our house upon the rock, if we build the firm foundation, we will withstand the storms. Hannah knew this as she came to God year after year, sharing her full self with God, having her faith built upon a rock. She remains faithful. So even in her answered prayer, in her greatest delight of having a son, she gives her son to God. So may we hear today, in whatever our longings, whatever we're longing, to lift it to God. Whatever we're going through, and our longings are vast. They are real. I journaled this week, writing down so many of the heavy things, I wrote them all down. All of the changes, the trying to hold things together, the amount of loss, the amount of grief, the concerns we have for our children, the worries we have for our nation, are entering into winter now, this in a holiday season, seeing all of the warnings that have not been heeded as they should, that it should have never been this bad. And now we know the infection rates are exponentially rising. And we combine all of this, and it's a lot, right? Too much, really, for any one of us. But as we see with Hannah, this is not too much for God. So may we, like Hannah, lift all of it, whatever it is for you, whatever it is together, lift all of our concerns. Let's lift them up to God. Lift them high. Share them, speak them. There's something freeing to say it out loud, to say it, to leave it to God. It makes a big difference to lift it up, to trust God with our deepest longings, knowing that God hears us. And like Hannah, not all of our prayers are answered in the time frame that we would like. But God does hear our prayers. God is with us in our longings, and in due time, God does answer. Most importantly, God answers by giving us life. In our coming to fully know this, this is the beginning of finding life. As our scripture reminds us, we find life, we find it by giving it away. We find it by sharing it. We find it by making ourselves less and making God more. So in all things, give it to God with everything. This is Hannah's story, a story of life, a story of trusting God. And in trusting God, enter her son, Samuel. Samuel, who becomes a judge, a prophet, who proclaims, he's the one who proclaims, "Here I am, Lord," who is a judge, faithfully brings us King David. The line that leads to Jesus. This is Hannah's story. Friends, in everything, and all that is hard, and in all that is good, let's give it to God. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
7 months. 7 months we have been adapting, changing, evolving, and yes, we have continued worshiping. We have continued serving. We've continued being the church. Thanks be to God. This is a time of trial. Thank you for approaching this time with courage, kindness, unity, and with grace. As we enter this time of sharing our gifts, the time where we practice that it is more blessed to give than to receive, helps strengthen our resolve to give as we are able. This is a month where our budget includes 3 payrolls, and we ask for your help. If you can, give a little more. In everything, we give thanks. Thank you for showing up. Let us pray. Holy God, maker of all of us, receive our offerings this day. Take all that we have. Accept all that we do. It is all for you and for your glory. Amen.
Amen. So many gifts this week. Tremendous job, everyone, and all the contributions. So thank you for all for sharing Thank you for so many that helped with the holly, holly, hallelujah. So nice to see each one of you. And thank you, Clara and Adosa. Thank you, Becky. Thank you, Martha. Thank you, everybody. As we continue to navigate this time, I'm actually encouraged. I continue to be encouraged by all of you. And so thank you. Thanks for strengthening. And also, as so many are reaching out, I'm praying for me as well. So grateful for you. Update this week on Ray Gracek. He had open heart surgery Friday. He is recovering very well. He received a note this morning that he's healing well, that things are going. So continue to hold him in prayer, and continue to hold Alice in your prayers, as it's good to have the updates and the good news. So we surround you with our love and in our prayers. Thank you. Let us bring everything. I'm going to be watching the chat. So here as this is prayers of all the people, share your prayers in the chat, and we will together lift those up. Okay. Let us pray. Loving God, we feel at times as if we are being tested. As one crisis passes and another one comes in its wake. As hurricanes churn over warming waters, and we see fires burn on the West Coast. Injustice follows injustice, and the pandemic will not cease. How long? How long, O Lord, how long? We cannot endure without a sure sense of your presence, dear God. We cannot rest without a glimpse of your power. While we want to remain faithful, we cannot help but lag in zeal. Hear our cries for help, we pray. Gracious God, knowing all too well that today's problems are enough for today, we entrust to your compassionate care all of the burdens that we can no longer carry, the worries that we can no longer bear. Take from us the anxieties that threaten to overtake us, the grief of cumulative losses, the fear for our well-being and that of those we love, the shame of deeds we cannot undo, and the doubts that prevent us from moving forward. We hand them over. We lift them to you right now, believing that our Lord intercedes for us and that the Spirit translates our sighs too deep for words. Merciful God, you never abandon us. Your faithfulness to the covenant you make with your people is unwavering. You walk with us. You go before us. You envelop us with your goodness and your grace. Help us to feel your close presence with every breath, with each heartbeat. May our awareness of your nearness empower us to do justice, to love kindness, to walk humbly with you so that others will come to know your love through our witness. Make of us a grateful, joy-filled people, a light to which others are drawn. Glorious God, we are told only to ask, and that in asking we will receive. So we ask now for whatever is on our hearts, whatever weighs on our minds, what calls from our souls. You know it before we even name it. As we lift our prayers, we lift our prayers for Ray Gracek. As Alice updates us, shares with us that he's doing well and he's recovering, and we celebrate with them as we share in prayer for strength and healing in his recovery. We also pray, dear God, we lift Rose's prayer for her dear friend Sue, who passed away this past week, and for her family. May God surround Sue's family and Rose and everyone with compassion and peace and love. We share the prayers from Bob, the Thanksgiving for a new roof, and the hardworking guys that made this happen. We lift prayers for Dwayne's family. His cousin Terry passed away from cancer. Prayers for her family, for Dwayne's Aunt Cora and cousin Sherry, for the loss of their daughter and sister. I'm going to keep scrolling here to make sure for earlier ones and see if anything comes through from Facebook here. Okay. Any other ones? Let's see here. I think we've caught all the prayers. Dear God, as we lift all these prayers, the ones spoken and unspoken, You desire what is best for your beloved world. You plan a hope-filled future for us. You refuse to give up on your good and beautiful creation. Help us to dream your dreams, envision your will until the day when Christ returns and all is well. We pray in the name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, the one who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. Join us in our closing song. How many of you at home are going, it's a nice to have the connection, how music, how gathering like this, how together we are connected and we're brought together with what's most important, That's having God at the center. God at the center of all of our lives. So thank you all. Thanks for your continued care, your continued love, your showing up. You're now be bold and courageous. Being bold and courageous, go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to all that is good and render no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the afflicted, show love to everyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit, the blessing of the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Know God's love. Know the peace and the unity of the Holy Spirit. Know the love of Jesus Christ. We share all of this. We share all of this with hope going forward. Be light into the world. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, go and serve the Lord. Amen. Hey, y'all. We're going to bring you all forward. So I move back into my Indiana roots and say, hey, y'all.